Okay, here's a picture of my finished sketch. And I'm going to be showing you how to draw this. So for those of you that uploaded the reference photo, this is not the reference photo, this is my photo. This is my drawing that I did from the reference photo. It took me about 4.5 hours. Obviously, we're not going to spend 4.5 hours here, so I'm going to do things a little bit differently. So, is everybody ready to start? Okay, this is the iPad Retina screen, 1536 by 2048. And this is what I recommend to use for this drawing. If you use a different canvas, it won't give you the same effect as this iPad Retina screen. The first thing I do is I move the active layer down from number 2 to number 1, and I also pinch the canvas. Usually what I do is I press the two arrows at the bottom of the canvas to give you more space to draw. That's the size and opacity bar and the color block, they'll disappear. So I would recommend you do that. And also, we're going to be grabbing colors from my reference photo. So I'm going to go ahead and get my reference photo by touching the rectangle in the top left corner. So there's my reference photo. And the first thing I do is I make a fill layer. So in the tools, you go to fill. Make the threshold about 5% and go ahead and fill. Okay, so there is my fill color. Now I'm going to start drawing the sky, and so I will stretch the reference photo over my canvas. Okay, I need to go to procedural. Size is going to be 75. That's all the way up. Opacity is going to be 100%. So I go ahead and put it on 100%. And I just start drawing my colors. I'm going to go ahead and grab a different color, this pink color. Well, now I somehow touched the wrong thing and my reference photo disappeared. So I've got it back again. Go ahead and grab the pink color. And there again, the opacity, if you haven't got the instructions, the size is the bristle brush is 75%. The opacity is 100%. Okay. Then I had sort of determined the sky is going to go down how far, and that's why I have put the reference photo here. So I just make this line on the left to about as long, as far down as I think it's going to be. Then I take the reference photo and I stretch it across. So I can do the middle. And of course, I can't see your comments, so if you're saying something, well, Linda will tell me. I guess, because I can't see the comments. My reference photo is...
Oh, they're being very quiet.
They are.
Yeah, they must be drawing like crazy.
And how many people are drawing?
I have no idea, but it's awfully quiet. Mark said if they misbehave, they'll be bristled. So that's probably why they're so quiet.
Mark said what?
They'll be bristled if they're not behaving.
Oh, that's exactly right. And Black Pond will do it.
Okay.
Whatever that means.
Okay, what's next?
Oh, don't be pushy. This is not responding like it does on a normal drawing.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's the way it usually is on live streams. We're going to be here for 3 days at this point.
Then we need those cupcakes for sure.
Now, BP likes tacos. Linda, can you go get some tacos?
Hey, Taco Bell's right down the street.
Yeah, good. Oh, man.
BP said performance may be different while streaming. And then he has a little picture of him drooling. Okay,
so this is very much slower than what the regular drawing is. So like I say, we could be here for 5 hours. And I don't think that I'm going to be able to do it for 5 hours. Now we're going to blend the edges, and that's with 50 and 20. So take it down to 50, take it over to 20. And so I just keep grabbing each different color and kind of blending in the edges. And obviously, if I was doing this for a real drawing, I wouldn't be doing it so quickly. I would be taking my time. I'm trying to do this as quickly as possible because I don't want to have you guys here for 2 years. So you just keep grabbing different parts of your color and blending. And I actually wasn't going to do this, but it's sort of, well, it's interesting. So anyway, let's just call this sky good. So the next thing we're going to do is the left mountain. And go to the next layer. And because the left part of the mountain is pretty time consuming, and actually I realized that I picked a drawing that was more complicated than I should have, but once I started it, I thought, you know, I really like this, and I'm just going to do the best I can. And, I mean, if I spend 2 hours on the stream, I mean, most everybody will be gone, but I'll stay. Actually, it took me, when I was doing it quickly, which I surely have not been doing now, it took me an hour and 22 minutes. The original drawing took me 4.5 hours. So anyway, I grabbed the top of the mountain and I moved this reference over so I can kind of tell where the mountain is. And I need to, let's see. Size 8, opacity 100%. So we go to make it all the way down, size 8, opacity 100%. Okay, so then I'm just going to draw this outline. Oh my. Well, we're going to cover that up anyway, so it doesn't, you know, obviously it's not exactly where I would put it, but I'm not going to worry too much about it. Because I will provide you, when I upload my drawing, I will put the reference photo as a work in process. So that way, if you want to go back and practice the bristle brush, you can use my reference photo and see what you can create. I mean, everybody can create something different, I'm sure. I really don't try and go completely by the reference. I mean, on some of the things I do, I may, but on this particular one, I really didn't. I don't like the trees. And so I made my own trees. So we've got the outline of the mountain. And now we're going to grab the bottom part of the mountain. It's black. Size 40, opacity 75%. Size 40. Okay. So I'm just trying to tell myself that's where the mountain's going to be. So that's why I'm doing this. Okay, so now the trees are going to be the next layer. And I take my reference photo. And I stretch it so that I can see how tall the tree is. It's black. And the tree is going to be... In the procedural tool, it's going to be 8 and 100%. But this particular one, I want to edit the brush, the bristle brush. Oh, how interesting. I already had it at 101. Okay, I'm going to... it had already been edited, but I actually, on my drawing, I started out with the density at 75% and the thickness at 2. Maybe that's why this is harder. Okay, well, anyway. So, for the trees, you want to edit your brush And you want the density to be 100% and the thickness 1. So you just come up here, mark, just make a little mark. That's where the tree's going to be. So I'm not going to do it right now. So we're going to go up to another layer for the second tree and mark it. And then what I want to do is just excuse me, I'm reading here because I, of course, don't have this all memorized, but we're going to establish the bottom of the trees with a 65% and the, so we go, okay, first we want to go to the bottom and reset this so the rest of our drawing is not going to be in the edited with that thickness, the density, and the thick. So I'm going to reset it so it's back to 75% and 2 thickness. Okay, so now I want it to be at 65%. Okay. 65%. Okay, so I'm just going to establish the bottom of the trees. I think it, the bristle brush works better now when we're drawing bigger things and not in the edited mode. So maybe that was the problem on my sky. So those are just little things that you pay attention to. And of course, when you're drawing, I mean, we all pay attention to those things. I'm sure, well, obviously I had no idea streaming was harder. Well, I knew it would be harder than drawing anyway. Okay, so those are the bottom of the trees. So now I'm going to do the water. But I do want to move this below the mountain because I don't want to be drawing on top of my mountain. So you move your layer below your mountain, and now we're going to draw the water. So what I do is I'm going to grab the palest color on my reference, the lilac color. I've got it at 65 and 100. And I'm going to make sure I'm on the right layer. Okay, I'm below the mountain and above the sky. Okay, so then I just go ahead and start doing my water. And so, what not to do is make sure you haven't edited your brush when you start doing this, because it's much easier. This is much easier than when I was doing the sky. So, I guess we can all learn. Oh, actually, I said 75 and 100. Okay. Not that it's going to matter. Because with the bristle brush, one reason I love it so much is even if I had chosen an opacity that, and am I pronouncing that right?
Sounds good to me.
What?
Sounds good to me.
Oh, okay. If I chose an opacity of something that wasn't what I really needed, you just keep going over and over with the bristle brush, and it's like painting. You get what you want. So as long as you raise your bristle brush, if you were to go like this, see how the paint gets thinner.
I'm on FaceTime with you.
Uh-oh. Okay.
We're on a whole new different thing now, but can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, now I'm going to do the white part of the water. 75 size and opacity 100%, the same as above. In other words, the same as the lilac color. So, oh, that looks green to me. Let's try that again. And I don't get too picky about, you know, trying to get it perfect. And certainly on this, I'm going to kind of leave it to you to take the reference photo and the instructions and do your own thing and make it yours. So I'm just kind of, obviously if I was doing a drawing, I wouldn't be doing it so quickly. I would be, you know, paying more attention to the details, but this will work. Yes, we can hear everything you say. Your grandkids, Linda?
Yes.
Yeah, there's nothing like grandkids. You're just lucky to have them locally.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so now we're drawing the blue part. And actually the instructions say 35 and 50, which is not a really big deal. I went ahead and used the 75 and 100. I mean, it pretty much works. I think it's, and obviously if you don't like it, we all, in every one of our drawings, if we don't like something, we undo it or we clear the layer. I can't think of how many times I erased those doggone trees for my actual drawing. I was having a terrible time drawing pine trees. I erased them, I cleared them, finally, I just said, you know what, this has got to be good enough. That's just how it is. And everybody is going to draw the kind of tree that they want to. If you like what the reference photo is, you can draw that too. I just didn't care for it. It's actually, the whole picture is a little more abstract than what I normally draw. But, I mean, it works. Okay, so we've got the blue area, and now we're going to go up and grab the purple line. So that's going to be a size 8, and I'm not being real picky when I do this, because this is somewhat of an abstract drawing. I suppose I could have done that quicker with a line, but oh well. Okay, then we're going to take this plum color on the lake and just... Actually, I think I had the size bigger. Purple and plum lines, 15% 60. Oh well. 15%. That's a little better. And I think the more you make it yours, the better off you are, really. If you don't like something that's on the reference photo, just change it. Make it just how you want it. Make the colors that you like. So, yes. Oh, that's okay. The purple and plum lines, we've got that colored shading on the lake. Okay, what I did on that was I grabbed this dark color up by these purple and plum lines. Same size, 35 and 50. So you're just going to take and sort of put some color just various places. So anyway, we're just kind of drawing without a reference. So, I'm going to grab the darker shade so that I can put it in this area. Linda, what are you doing? Oh, you're hurting my ears. So now we're going to blend these areas, and what I do to blend them is I just grab this lilac color of the lake And I make, or I made, or I'm making, it's going to be 35 and 20. So you reduce your opacity down to 20. And you just kind of go over it, and it makes it kind of look like what the reference photo is. Anyway, I like it. And then I always like to make ripples on the lake. So I'm going to use an 8. And 20. And I'm going to grab the darker color and then just make some ripples. And then to what I did when I wanted to make this kind of the area right above the white, I wanted to make it a little smaller. So I went to 30. And 50. And I grab the lilac color and then I just kind of go right down it. And just keep doing it till it looks, you know, more like what I want. Obviously, it's bigger in the reference photo, so if you were doing it, I mean, you can make it the way you want to make it. The dark pink thin line across the water, a size 8, 100%. And I had a terrible time trying to, when I was doing my final drawing, I did this drawing actually 4 times because I was practicing. I had a hard time grabbing this because it was, so I kept making it bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger so I could grab it. Okay, so now, yeah. What's the question? I think I do longer strokes. Was that the question? I can't really hear you too well. No, maybe I don't. Wait a minute. Let's see what I do. I guess I haven't really paid much attention. Yeah, I think I do longer strokes. I guess it depends on if I'm... Well, you can't really do too long of a stroke with a bristle brush because it fades. So you have to keep raising your stylus, which in some instances, to have it fade is great. It was something I actually discovered on, I think, my fourth drawing. I thought, wow, look at this. This is what it does. This is really cool. So now we're going to do these lines at the bottom of in the blue area. So we're going to grab this darker color, size 8, 75%. And of course, when you're drawing with the bristle brush, I mean, you just keep experimenting. Whatever works, whatever looks good, you know. So you draw, try a 65, and you think, I don't know, that doesn't look good. I maybe want to do this. I mean, that's with anything you draw, I think. This is a really versatile tool, though. I mean, it worked well for everything on this drawing. And of course, it's great for Afremov. So just put your little lines and just kind of fiddle around with it. And like I say, I don't pay too much attention to, is it going to look exactly like the reference? And here I blurred these lines. So I had blur on 25 and 40%. So I'm just going to kind of blur some of them. And obviously this water doesn't look just like the reference, so you can spend more time on it, making it look like the reference. But for our purposes, I'm going to go on to do the land, because I know you don't want to be here for 3 hours. So we're going to create another layer, and we're going to move it under the mountain, but above the water. And we're going to use, go back to the procedural. Opacity 100%. Okay, so now we're just going to draw the land. Oops, we're supposed to get black. We don't want blue land. Can't even see the chat, but how come I can't see it? You guys could be talking about me and I wouldn't even know it.
Yeah.
Okay, Linda, I'm going to depend on you to tell me if they're talking about me. Although, why don't you say that they're saying great things? So I'd... And I can't see chat, so I wouldn't know if you're right or not. Oh, that's right. I'll look at it, and I'll actually know what anyone said. How interesting. Okay. Now we're going to do the greenish accents on the land 2540. So put the size back down to 25. Opacity 40. I'll try and just explain. We're through a good portion of it, really. We've got the mountain, a little more on the land. So anyway, now we've grabbed the green, just kind of, I don't get crazy. Oh, dark diversity, Dee Dee, thank you. So I'm kind of just putting some little green splotches in various places. So we're going to go on to something else right now. I'm going to go to the left mountain. So, pale blue and light purple area, size 40, 100%, size 40, 100%. So, you just, I guess, grab it from my reference. Just kind of put it all the way down the mountain. And even though in the reference it doesn't look like this color is well, we're going to cover it up with some the colors that you see on the reference. So just go ahead and put this, I guess it's kind of a, not white, but a pale blue. So then I just grabbed the light purple area and just went all the way down to the black. Yes, it is the base color, Kathy. Because I'm going to cover it up with the other shading. So So I'm going to grab the deeper purple, or the plum, size 15, opacity 100%. And just kind of put it where you want to put it. Small plum lines and shading, size 15-25. So I make the opacity go back down to 25. Now, grabbing the color. So now we're going to do the pale blue. Fifteen and 25. Maybe that's too white. I don't care for that. Okay, so I went and grabbed it at the bottom instead. And if you like it, you can just kind of put it wherever you want to put it. Shading. Grab the color at the top of the mountain. We're just going to go back and shade some of the areas. So I'm not really trying to achieve a perfect drawing because, like I said, mine took 4.5 hours. So I'm just kind of trying to show you the basics, and then you have the instructions, and I can upload them probably in my gallery since now they're in the forum. So I'll upload them in my gallery. So you can get them all at the same place. So as the instruction says, there's certainly more work needs to be done on the mountain. So now we're going to go back to the land and do some of the detail work. So that's going to be a size 8, 100% opacity. Oh, I edited the brush. Okay, so we're going to edit it to 100% with a thickness of 1. Grab the black. And then we're just going to come along the shoreline. And just kind of make some of these little things that you see on the reference. Well, there, that's better. So then if you you want to fill it in with a 2100. And you want to reset the bristle brush and the edit. And go back and just kind of fill in the parts I drew around the edges. And now the green and blue accents 25, 40. 25, 40. More green accents. And just kind of put them wherever you think they look good. I don't make myself crazy. Did you lose me? The microphone went off for some reason. Okay, so now we're going to put some of those blue. You can see that the bristle brush, if you just touch it, even though it's a larger size, you still get this tiny little strokes. So I think that's pretty cool. And of course I could put it on the on mode so that I don't get outside the lines, which I probably should have done. Handy little part of our app. So take the on mode off if you put it on, and maybe I'm thinking I have too much blue, so I'm going to just go back and maybe make them smaller by grabbing the black and just kind of making them smaller. Like I said, just whatever you think looks good is basically what I do with a reference. So now we're going to do the black and purple accents. You can see the little lines in front of the mountain. I'm calling those black accents, and then you can see the purple accents into the water. I'm going to make a new layer for that. Oh, I probably drew on my tree layer. Oh well. Maybe I didn't. Okay. I'm sure everybody's done that anyway. Okay, so this is going to be the accent layer. Size 25%. Opacity 60. And I go ahead and I'm going to grab the purple. Just kind of make these little squiggly looking things. You can make them bigger, littler, just however you want to make them. And I might even go back and edit my brush on the little ends and make the thickness smaller, because it's that's kind of what it looks like. That may be moving over and okay, now we're going to do the lines, and so you want to reset your bristle brush. So I made the lines 15%, with 100% opacity, and then I changed the icon to the line, the shape, I mean. So I'm in my line, shape, oops, it should have been black. Just kind of put the lines here and there and everywhere. I must have pressed something. Oh, I pressed the close without thinking. Okay, just keep doing your lines, and they should be straight. Some of mine are not. I mean, unless you don't want straight lines. It's kind of up to you. So now we're going to edit the bristle brush again and put it back to 100% thickness 1. And we're going to go back and change the, just kind of draw on the lines and make them different sizes, because they're not all the same size. And I'm going back to freehand. Just either on the right-hand side or the left-hand, the left. Just making them different shapes. So just keep making your lines different shapes. Go back and reset your bristle brush so that it's not the density that we had. Just it's back to 75 and 2. And we're going to go and put more of the black area around those lines. I've added a 25 and 35. So I just kind of filled in around them. So we're just going to continue filling in. And it looks like there's some blue areas. So obviously this does not match the reference photo, but we're gonna go on to the trees, because if you take the reference photo and you can do your own drawing, that would be fine. So okay, there's the tree on the right. So we're going to do the tree on the right, because then we're going to transform it and make it smaller, so we have our second tree. So for this, we're going to edit the brush, go to 100% density, thickness of 1, and actually, I don't think I'm going to use that, but at least, whoops. And down to 8 and 100%, and black. So oh, I hate that. I don't draw the best trees, I have to tell you. I could have just cleared the layer. So just draw your tree however you want it to be. What I did is I actually looked at some references because I didn't like these trees. And just drew it. Everybody draws probably different types of trees anyway. So whatever you like. And then I filled in the middle with a 40 at 100%. And I'm going to leave it on the edited bristle brush because I may go back. I know on the one I was doing this morning, I ended up going back and adding more. So just fill it in. I practically covered up the other tree, so obviously I'm going to transform it. So I'm not going to get too crazy about it because I think you're all going to draw your own trees if you do this. But this does show nicely what the bristle brush. Okay, does everybody hear me again? I'm sorry, I guess I must have pressed the close. Surely I'll get better at this if I ever do it again. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to make the second tree by adding another layer, moving it below this layer, and copying down so we have two trees. And then on the second tree, we're going to transform and we're going to make it smaller. So maybe 80%, 80% done. So let's see what that looks like. Not bad. Okay, it's fine with me. Okay, let's see. The only thing we really have to do is draw the mountain underneath the trees, and you can barely see it, so it's not going to take long. I don't know how many hours we've been doing this. How many hours have we been doing it? Oh my gosh. Thank you, Mary Lou. Okay, so we're going to do the mountain on the right. So let's move it behind the trees. Fifty percent size and 100% opacity. Okay, so I just try and find this little blue part that you can barely see, and I just kind of draw and I'm going to make the mountain bigger. What the heck, I like it. And we can even move over our tree on the left, which I think I will. I'm going to transform it and move it because I want to see more mountain. So that's what I did. So now we can grab some of the purple. And that's going to be at 1545. Just kind of put some little purple things on the mountain. And of course, well, the one thing I forgot when I was making the second tree was I had it on the edge of the canvas, actually off the canvas. So now the other tree has got that, but that's okay. I mean, if you were actually doing your drawing, it would be easy to fix. You just make more little, well, I can actually fix it. We're going to go back to 8 and 100%. We're going to, oh, we forgot to get out of edit, but anyway, so we can just, because that tree, oops, we do want to continue making it black instead of purple. So we're on the smaller tree. So you can just come and make the branches. I mean, you could make them bigger. You could do most anything you wanted. And I noticed that it's actually in a different place than where my mark is, so I don't know where my mark, well, if I had time, obviously, I would find where the mark is because I've done that before. I've had stuff on layers and had to go through every single layer to discover where the mark was. So I'm sure you've all done that. It's not that layer. It's that layer. There it is. So I just would erase it. Of course, I'm erasing with the tiniest, so I'm going to get back in a bigger brush, so I'm going to reset it. Maybe it doesn't matter. Let's see. Oops. I didn't mean to do that. So I'm just erasing my mark because it obviously the tree got put at a different place. So this is really all I was going to do for the class because it's already been, 2 hours? Well, not quite 2 hours. Amazing. I thought I'd get tired before that. But I was having so much fun. Anyway, if you want to draw this, you're welcome to, because when I upload my drawing, I will put the reference photo as a work in process, and I also will upload the instructions onto my gallery. So, does anybody have any questions? Thank you, Maggie. No one has any questions? What rules for bristle compo? I would think I would like to do a fill layer and use blur, and other than that, majority of the bristle brush. Does anybody have any other thoughts? You're welcome. Missed. Thank you, Mary Lou. I like the blur. I really would like to have that in the compo, and I like the fill. Multiple entries, I say no. Yes, all drawn in Sketch Club, no image loads. Thank you, Leslie. Tanya, thank you so much. Thank you, guys. Oh, you're making me feel so good. So, anyway, thank you, everybody, for participating. I really appreciate it. You were great. You were so quiet.